G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and it's time for video log number 7. Not done one of these in quite a while, and I've actually been playing a lot of other games since the last one, so it's going to be interesting to see what people are writing in about, what might have showed up, a couple of things that I got for myself as well, so I'll be showing you that, and let's get into it. This first one came from Will. I don't know your address because I don't see a return address on it, but it doesn't matter, I don't like giving out addresses anyway. But it's a package, and it's a Reaper mug. Check out this. It's a Reaper mug. That's actually really detailed. It's like embossed. It's a little bit raised up. I actually made a Mr. Paladin mug not too long ago. My son got it for me, and the Mr. Paladin logo shows up when the mug is hot. So it's really cool, I like it. And you know, I drink hot tea and such because I'm Australian. You know, I don't do this cold iced tea that they drink around here. I sometimes drink a lot of colas and stuff. But look at this, this is a deep mug. It's got the Overwatch logo on the back. That's sizable. You know, this is the size of my hand. It is not small. I'm definitely gonna be able to use that one. Recently, I've finished reading through this, The Angels of Darkness, which is a Warhammer 40k book. I was wanting to read up a little bit more about the Dark Angels because they are a chapter that I like. Been playing some Eternal Crusade and such. I don't know, are you guys grooving on that? There's been a lot of crazy reviews about it. I think I kind of pushed the release early, so I don't know how that game's going to end up or if it's going to have a lot of troubles. You know what I'm saying? Here's something I actually got for myself. I wanted this one, so I know what's in this one. It's got that extra strong tape on it. Got this because Sombra hadn't come out yet, but I'm probably gonna have to get the Sombra one too. This is the little Reaper. Look at him. Isn't he so mean and cute at the same time? That is freaking hilarious. I'll put him up next to my little spy who's over. Where is he? He's up there. Oh, he's got his two little guns too. Check out that. Alright, I like him. He's mean, and he's over there. This one's from Micah. I don't even know where that's from. Micah, you know where you're from. I don't want to give out anyone's details anyway. You know, I like letting people know that, you know, who it's been sent by, but I don't want to, like, have people track them down or anything. It's part of the reason why I don't give out a lot of my details online, because I don't want people messing with the kids, you know, messing with my children. Gotta defend the homestead. Oh, this one's got a letter with it. And a gift on, so let's see, let's do the what's in the package first. Okay, so what we got is these couple of ducks, and they're like traditional Korean gift, right? And they're like wedding ducks, so you'd give them to a couple and you'd sit them with the bills touching, I'm guessing, right? I believe that's what it says. But if there's trouble in the home and the husband gets home and the ducks are facing away from each other, you better sort it out, you know what I'm saying? So that's kind of neat. Let's see what letter comes with it. Okay, and the letter reads, Dear Mr. Paladin, I was out in the shopping district the other day, and I remembered that in one of your mail videos, you said you like knowing where people watch you from. With that in mind, I decided to get you something from South Korea, because I haven't seen you receive anything from Asia yet. What you have gotten from me is known as the wedding ducks. There is another paper in the package that tells a story of the ducks. That was some of what I told you. Thank you for all the helpful videos. Because of you, I can properly play as a spy. Your videos also help me figure out how not to be fooled by enemy spies. That's what I like. I had a couple of people who pyromane recently talk about that on my How to Spot a Spy video. They're like, haha, you've shown us how to spot spies. And I'm like, that's what the videos are there for. They're there to help everyone. I don't mind if you main spy or you don't main spy, just as long as you keep improving and you keep having fun. I'm totally cool with all of it. Two quick questions he has. Have you always lived in the United States? No, I came over here about 17 years ago now. I came over here in the end of 1998. So that's been some time now. Do you plan on doing any MVM with Dane, Raja, Funky, Artie, GPS, etc.? Since that first video, I actually did some more MVM. I did like some meta-breaking MVM with Trav and the rest of the gang. So that was fun. I think Array was even in on that one. So yeah, check them out. Might jump into some again. They're kind of fun to do every once in a blue moon. I mean, I don't play against the AI too much because I find AI to get a little bit boring because I keep doing the same thing. And a meta does develop where you're meant to play a certain way. Otherwise, people get upset at you. But I like doing things out of the normal. So, you know, it's not appreciated in a regular game. But sure, if you jump into a game with a bunch of friends, they don't mind. You just play. You just have fun. Oh wow, this one, I hope I pronounce your name correctly. Stanislav? From Kazakhstan? Wow, Kazakhstan, I don't think, I'm gonna have to like, look up a map to find out exactly where that is. I know it's east of Europe, you know, I'm Australian. Once you get off Australia, I don't know too much. I know where Asia is, I know where the United States is, South America, all that stuff, but when you start getting into some of these smaller countries in the middle of Africa or in the Europeans, I don't know. Oh, this is cool. Okay, first it's a cross stitch here of Fry. Oh, let me put him on my head. I'm not sure if this is for me or if this is just a really good cross stitch. I like it. That's neat. Let's see what's in the letter. Hi, my name is Stars. I am a 23-year-old Russian guy from Kazakhstan. Yeah, that is too much info for just one sentence. No, that's actually good. That helps. Knowing that it's in Russia, I can help pin down what I'm talking about. One of the reasons I write this letter was to show you that you have tons of fans all over the world, and they aren't necessarily young teens or kids. Awesome. I've actually been getting things in the last vlog was from the parents of some of the kids. Also, there's been other people reaching to me on Facebook and Twitter that are all over the world, all different places, all different faces. The support is awesome. I recently started cross-stitching and I wanted to send you something, but I couldn't find a decent spy pixel art, so I made a good old Fry. I like Fry. Futurama is great. I want more Futurama. They're actually doing like a Simpsons marathon at the moment over here because they had 600 episodes. So it's along the same lines, but I miss some of the older Futurama stuff. I main medic and your videos help me a lot. Thank you. I hope you liked the recent medic video. Did you like that? I like to off-class to medic quite a lot, so I hope that helped. A lot of medics, first of all, pointed out that I wasn't using a crossbow, but, you know, I switched to crossbow later in the video. The reason I wasn't using the crossbow at the start was actually because I did that giveaway where I gave out all of my medic stuff and I had to get some of it back. And when I started doing the video, I didn't have all my items that I'd usually have, so. So your videos helped me at fighting spies. Your videos also helped me to improve my medi game. But unfortunately, my pockets seem to die to spies too often. But I just don't have enough time to warn them. Yeah. When I warn people about spies, the first thing I say is spy, okay? Say spy first. Then give them a location and give them what they're wearing, if you know it. So, you know, something along the lines of, like, spy as demo man at the sniper window. You know, something like that. So the instant they hear spy, they can react, and then they can start looking, and then you pin down the location real fast for them. You know what I'm saying? It comes back to back in the day, you didn't have voice comms in game. So I used to have key bindings and the key bindings would be for spy, and then I'd give a location, and I'd use the keypad actually, so I'd have a button press, and then I'd go over to the number pad, so it would be like, the button press would be spy as 9 for sniper, and then at location, and then the keypad would be reassigned to a couple of basic, you know, things that were in a lot of the maps. So that's where I got into the habit of it. As you said in your videos, first stab is always free. You're not always thinking spy all the time. I mean, I get stabbed. Who doesn't get stabbed? You're not thinking spy, you get stabbed, and then you're suddenly a bit more spy aware. So basically, that fry picture is what my face looks like after that first stab. Yep, that's about the truth of it. You get stabbed and you're like, Please keep doing what you're doing. I love your content. Best wishes. Excellent. I will keep doing that. That was a great letter. Okay, I also got this poster that I actually want to hang up over there sometime. I think it's a little too big to actually show on the webcam. Oop. But it's the Assassin's Creed Syndicate poster. Can you see that? So I'm probably going to have to get a frame for that so it'll sit up nice and flat, because otherwise it's looking like a scroll here. And yeah, probably up on the wall over behind me, because I like the Assassin's Creed series. I don't like the platform it's on. I actually want to pick up Watch Dogs 2, but I've played Witcher 3. Witcher 3 is great along those same lines. If you've got a computer that can push the graphics on that, it is a great game. Some adult content though, so for the younger kids, give that one a pass. This one doesn't say who it's from, but the stamp on it indicates it's from Great Britain or England or Europe in general. I mean, it's the Queen, so I don't know how far out of Europe you'd go, especially with Brexit happening. And it says, Mr. Paladin. Hi, Mr. Paladin. I don't think you'll receive this letter drawing, but I'd like to thank you for all your effort in your videos and helping me with my disguise choice and trick stabs, as I am also a spy main, but an orange box player because I don't have a laptop or a computer. Good luck with your kids. It's also silly, but can you tell them I said hi? From Romeo. Hey, absolutely. Okay. Yeah, I'll tell them. Actually, I'll tell them now. If you guys cover your ears, though, I'm going to holler, okay? Okay. Omega Bot, Goblin King, Romeo says hi. They're saying, like, what? What? I'll find out what they said later on. They're like, what? You see, what's funny is I tell them, you know, I'm about to do this recording, so, you know, don't make any noise back there, you know, don't need slamming of doors or anything. So for me to be shouting out stuff to them, it's like a conflict of instructions. You gotta watch that you don't do that as a parent, that you don't say one thing and then, like, do the opposite, because that really messes up, you know, kids trying to follow you instructions. I hear them talking back there. I don't know what they're saying. But I bet it's along those lines. I bet it's like, Dad told us not to make too much noise while he's recording. Let's see if I can find a name on this one. No, but it's from Richmond, okay? So if you're from Richmond, this one's from you. I'm writing to tell you how happy I am that you started back on TF2. You have no idea how giddy I was when I saw a new TF2 video on your channel. I also love that you made another Pretty Fly for a Kunai video. I actually did another one recently, so this person's especially happy because I've got 2 extra Kunai videos up recently. As it is my favorite knife. I hope you keep making TF2 videos and stay faithful to God. Cool. Please shout me out on your Facebook page. Okay, I see who your username is. I won't shout you out just because I don't want people to know where you live. Like I said before, I'm trying to protect people. It's one thing for me to put my name and info out there. I don't like putting other people's info out there. Okay, and some sketched up artwork. Looks like a spy. Spy with no balaclava on. Okay, so that's all the letters for today, but I've got a few other things I want to talk about. First, you know, I keep getting on different shirts. Do you like the shirts? I paused my game to be here. I've actually been playing some Civ 5, so I'm interrupting a Civ 5 game in order to do this video. I hope you all appreciate it, because Civ 5, I mean, you start a game and you end up 2 weeks' time and you're going like, where have I been, man? It's like, whoa, it's just time is gone. One thing I do want to talk about, though, and it's been kind of getting... it's been getting to me, okay? I can tolerate a lot, but this is finally getting to me, okay? People who come onto videos and say that Overwatch is like TF2, or that Paladins is like Overwatch, or that Paladins is like TF2, or that TF2 is like Overwatch, and this copied that, and that copied this. I'm getting tired of it, okay? I'm getting tired of answering the same question all over. So let's put this issue to rest, okay? Let's lay it all out on the table, okay? First of all, a couple of pieces of information. A lot of games copy each other, okay? A lot of games copy ideas from other games. Back in the day when Sega came out with Sonic the Hedgehog, everyone was all up in arms. Oh my goodness, they're just copying Mario. Sonic is so much like Mario. If I went to you today and I said how Sonic was just a copy of Mario, what would you be doing? You'd be like blank face and like, seriously, Sonic's a copy of Mario? But that was what it was at the time. I mean, it was the major platform release character that came with their game system, and it was a side-scrolling platformer. Side-scrolling platformer. That's about the only thing they had in common. It was a side-scrolling platformer, okay? So let's take a look at Overwatch and TF2. They're first-person shooters. You select different characters. That's about it. I mean, there's a payload. Okay, sure, payload game mode is probably the same. But do you think TF2 really copied King of the Hill and such as that? No, these concepts, they're kind of natural, okay? Once you see them, it's kind of natural. Once there are, the game modes go around. The original Team Fortress brought in Capture the Flag, but they weren't the first things to do Capture the Flag, right? There was Capture the Flags out there. They introduced classes, okay? So what, are we going to say that Battlefield, the Battlefield series, because that had different classes in it, did that copy TF2? Well, it kind of did with the classes, but it's not enough to worry about. I mean, unless the game companies are suing each other, why are we as players fighting about it? There's no sense. In this world, I want to see remakes and rehashes and, you know, upgraded HD qualities of a whole bunch of different games. There's a game I really like called Road Rash that they're bringing out, Road Redemption. And I'm like, yes, please bring this out. I know the concept was already around with Road Rash. Bring it out with Road Redemption, please. I like TF2, okay? I like Overwatch. I like those types of games. The more types of those games that are around is great for me. Unless these companies are actually suing each other, it's not so much of a problem. So, okay, so you go to Overwatch and to Paladins, and you're saying, well, you know, the Ruckus is kind of like the D.Va, and the Fernando is kind of like a mix of a couple of them too, and, you know, the Grover is kind of like Lucio because he's got the area heals. And it's like, you know, some of these skills, you know, they don't really... there's only so many ways you can heal someone, okay? You can directly heal them with a beam, with hitting them, with an area heal. So there's only so many creative ways to do healing, okay? So sure enough, you could say that, you know, this healer is the same as that healer. But are you going to say that, you know, a healer in Overwatch is like a healer in Battlefield where he throws the med pack? Because, you know, they throw the med pack to heal and they can revive people, you know? Did Mercy copy Battlefield because, you know, you had the pedals in Battlefield 2 and you could revive someone, so that's just like Mercy copying? No. Just let it go, okay? Just let it slide. If you want a proper history, I'll put a link down below about Paladins, because there's a big disparity right now between Paladins and Overwatch, because they are a very similar game type, but they were in development at the same time. and there are some similarities that people like to bring up all the time, but let's put that to rest. I'm putting a link in my comment below that I'd like you guys to see, and we can comment on it and talk about it all day, but just let it go with this whole, this game is a copy of this game. Unless those game companies are actually suing each other, us as gamers, we should just be rejoicing that there's more games, okay? Play whatever you like, okay? The market will determine if a game is terrible or not, okay? If it's terrible, nobody will play it. That's just going to be the nature of it. It's going to die out. Nothing you can do or say is going to stop that. Sure, you might be able to give it a snarky review somewhere, but that's about it. So I want to know your opinion on this. Are you kind of tired with people being at odds, or are you like me and saying, hey, there's no reason why a TF2 player can't get along with a Paladins player or an Overwatch player, or you can't play all three at the same time? Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Delle belle turbando a riposo, ma ci sento a toncino d'amor. Delle belle turbando a riposo, ma ci sento a toncino d'amor.